Hi guys, I'm here and today we're going to be doing a collective haul over the last two-ish weeks. So it's going to be everything that came in from Black Friday, all of my pre-orders, as well as back orders. So let's get started. It's going to be a long one. These are my rightstuf packages. There's one more on the floor because that one's really heavy and I cannot hold it with all of these as well. But let's get into it. I'm so excited. I honestly don't remember what I ordered and then what I back ordered that shipped. So, alright, so this is our first package from rightstuf. I think I have a few of these that only have like one or two volumes in them, so I'm gonna go ahead and open all of them right now, and then we'll go ahead and see what I got from those. So this is what was in those four, maybe five boxes. I'm not sure, but this is what we got, so we'll go ahead and run through them. So we have Dokyosei or Classmates Volume 6, and then I also have Banana Fish Volumes 13 and 14, and then in comparison to the Canada print Volume 12, you can see 13 and 14 are a little bit different. We also have Jujutsu Kaisen Volume 18, Hirano and Kagura Volume 1, and then Akinarichu Volume 5. The next one is actually a manhwa, it's called On or Off. This is Volume 2, and it's printed by Tokyopop. This is my favorite series that I've read this year, it's No Guns Life Volume 13. Run On Your New Legs Volume 3, and then last but not least, I have Blue Periods Volumes 10 and 11. So from that big rightstuf package that I said was really heavy, I now remember why I said it was heavy, because I forgot I had ordered the Soul Eater Perfect Editions. So these went on sale during their actual like Black Friday sale, not the holiday sale. I had gotten the 5 through 8 bundle, and then I also got 2 through 4 because I didn't have those yet. So that's what I got. So the next series I got, I believe it's been on sale at every like big sale that rightstuf has had for like the last year and a half, which is like how long I've been collecting manga. But Inside Mari has like, I feel like it's always been on sale, but it's usually sold out. But however, this time it wasn't, so I actually got 1 through 8. I think they had two separate bundles, maybe it was just one, I have no idea to be honest. But I ordered all of those. So just moving on to stuff that I got from Target, we're gonna open this first box right here. But yeah, so Target's holiday sale this year was actually, this is my first time buying manga from Target, actually. That is a lie. I actually bought the Akira box set from there because they had a huge sale, and I basically got it for, I think it was like 60% off or something like that. It was ridiculous. It was really cheap, so I bought it. But Target, I guess, has really good prices on manga. So I will have to say, this is my least favorite packaging for whenever I get manga. Or not just manga, like even just like regular books in mail, when it comes in these are so hard to open usually. Alright, and then this is the last one that I have from Target. This one feels really light, but I think I did order something else on Black Friday. So this is what I got from Target. Their Black Friday sale, I guess, was buy two, get one free on books. It was all books. I only got manga this time, but usually I do like to pick up books from Target too, because they have them for pickup, which is great. Unfortunately, none of the manga was available for pickup, so I did have to wait for it to ship here. But Target prices, so usually it'll already be discounted. Sometimes it's not, but that's like okay. So combined with the buy two get one free deal, I think these were all about 40 to 50% off, if I can do my math correctly. Maybe I can't do my math correctly, but yeah, so this was a steal. While we're on the topic, like I had mentioned, like how I don't like that specific Target box that they had shipped manga in, I especially do not like these. So I call these like ravioli packaging, because literally the inside of it, like the inside film, is all sticky. And usually it's really hard to get the manga outside of this packaging, so it's just super annoying when it comes in. This is the only thing that came ravioli packaged. It is the Soul Eater Perfect Edition Volume 9. So I had bought 2 through 8 on rightstuf because those were on sale, but Volume 9 wasn't included in the sale. So I went ahead and bought it during Books A Million's Black Friday sale, which was also the buy 2 get 1 free. It also included pre-orders, which was new. Usually it doesn't include pre-orders for the Books A Million sales, but this time it did, and I think I went a little bit too crazy. Purchased Death Notes Volume 2 and 2 and 4, and then I also had purchased Dead Man Wonderland Volumes 3, 8, and 9. And then I also got this from Books A Million. It was not on sale. However, I needed it. I had a coupon though, so I got this. This is the final Attack on Titan box set. This is the only series that I enjoy these mini box sets for, because look at these spines. You're not seeing these on my shelf. You're gonna be seeing the back of every box set on my shelf. You will never see me show these spines. But yeah, so this is the Attack on Titan box set. It's volumes 29 through 34. Alright, and that's all that I have for you guys today. I'm saying that like that was a small haul. That was most definitely not a small haul, but I hope you guys enjoyed it. As always, all my socials will be linked down below in the description. Make sure you subscribe and like this video, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.